Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see the details on Microsoft new Windows Terminal 1.0. Microsoft on Tuesday officially announced the release of Windows Terminal 1.0 for Windows 10. The new Windows Terminal is stable and ready for enterprise use. Windows Terminal is an open source tab UI based terminal application. Was originally announced at Microsoft's Build conference May 2019. The features includes multiple tabs, panes, Unicode and UTF-8 character support, a GPU accelerated text rendering engine, and the ability to create your own themes and customize text, colors, backgrounds, and shortcut key bindings. Windows Terminal allows you to run any command line applications inside tabs and panes. You can create profiles for each of your command line applications and open them side by side. Additionally, the terminal will automatically create profiles for you if you have Windows subsystem for Linux distributions or additional PowerShell versions installed on your computer. The terminal will create automatically the new profiles whenever you install new shell based applications. You can download the stable release from the Microsoft Store or from the GitHub. So let me show you that. Yeah, this is the GitHub URL, github.com/microsoft-terminal. You can download this, or you can even go into the Microsoft Store. You can search for Windows Terminal. Yeah, you can see app and preview. So preview is for kind of a testing one. Then this is the live one. You can select that one. Also, the documentations you can find out in this link, ENUS Windows Terminal. So all the details are available here. Okay, now let me configure this into my system. So you can click on this get. Okay. Okay, you own the app. Now click on install. It will try to download it. It's installing now. Okay, it's completed. I can launch it now. Okay. So when I launched it, if you see, like the PowerShell has the default profile. So you opened the Windows PowerShell, because we have the PowerShell installed into the Windows system. Also, if you go and click here, you can see other profiles. Like I have another profile, Ubuntu, then command prompt, because I have configured the Windows subsystem for Linux and the Ubuntu app. That's what I am seeing, this profile. How many shell applications you have, then all those profile will be automatically created. You can open a new tab of the default profile. Here our case is a PowerShell. You can click a plus symbol, or you can do a Control Shift T. So you can use this shortcut, Control and Shift and T. So let me try that. Control. Yeah, so it created a new tab with the same profile. But if you want a tab in a different profile, you can go to you can click on this button and click on the profile. It will create that. Yeah, it's created in a the Ubuntu command line. Also, you can run multiple cells side by side using panes. To open a pane, you can use the Alt Shift D. So you can this is the shortcut going to be Alt Shift plus D. So let me try that. Okay, Alt Shift D. Yeah, if you see, like it created a different pane. Now even I can keep Alt Shift D. Yeah, I can, how many panes I want, I can create it, so that you can work on the multiple windows. Yeah, so it will create the pane is created based on the selected or the active profile. So right now my active profile is this one, the Ubuntu. That's why it's created with the same profile. So if it is, if this is going to be my active profile, let me now see Alt Shift D. Yeah, it will create with that same profile. Also, like you can open the search dialog by typing Control Shift F. So this shortcut Control Shift F. So if you want, you can search anything. You can search it. Let's say ls. Yeah, maybe something I can search with Control Shift F. Yeah, search box will come. Now I am just typing ls. Sorry. Yeah, you can see that. So it will search from the bottom to top. So we can change the order also. Now, you to customize the settings of your Windows terminal, so you need to go to this one, settings, click on the settings. Now it will open the settings. It's in the JSON file. Now if you see here, like what is the schema this JSON is following, you can refer here. Also, you want to see the default settings, so you can hold Alt while clicking on the settings. If I do that, I will go to settings. I am clicking on the Alt button, then settings. So it opened another file now. Let me go and find out. Yeah, it opened. This is the default configuration. You can see all those configuration, whatever the default configurations available here. You will be able to change multiple values. If you see here, something called default profile. So it's pointing to a one of the profile. Even you can change the default profile based on what is your requirement. Also, you can, if you see here, there is a lot of other configuration within the profiles, like close on exit, font face, font size, hidden equal to false. You can hide it if required, the particular profile. Also, like whatever the data you want to, you can change it here. Also, like there is other configuration like schemes, color schemes, you can change it. So all those values, then also you will be able to change the binding keys, like shortcut keys also, you can change it. Now let us see like how to change a color option for the profile. So there is a two option, like let's say like there is a predefined color profiles or schemes, I can say. So there is multiple schemes already defined, you can see that these are all the predefined schemes. You can take one of the scheme. So let me take this this specific scheme. You can associate this scheme to your profile. So how you can do is, you need to go back to your settings.json. So here, yeah, this is the syntax. So just to go back to your settings.js, open settings.js, sorry, JSON. Now here, if you see, this is your profile detail. The settings.json having the minimal value. The whatever we were earlier seeing is the default JSON that have all the possible values, but this is having only the minimal values. Whenever required, you can override that. So I'm going to override this for this. Just add a comma and say, yeah, this is the profile. I'm going to use it. Now, if I go back. Yeah, okay, maybe that was the profile earlier using it. Let me change it to some different profile. Maybe this one should be okay. Okay, now should be okay. Yeah, now see that the profile is changed. So if I am not having this, the look and feel going to be totally different. Okay, maybe there is something I need to remove that comma. Yeah, it's a different. If I add this, whatever the profile I pasted, yeah, it's going to be different. Now, what you can do is you can like have a custom. You can another option. What you can do is you can go to this default. Just to copy this. I want to customize the same profile. Maybe you can have your own profile also. But I am just copying this. I want to customize this. So I will go into the schemes again. Yeah, add the scheme. How many schemes you want, you can add it. You can override or you can add new schemes. So I'm adding the scheme. Then I am going and changing some values here, color values, and yeah, if like that's enough for now. So I will go back. If you see the color options and background and all those things are changed. So like this, you will be able to override and change what are the values you required. You can change the default profile and all those things. Okay, you can refer this particular specific document for more detail on the overview document from Windows terminal. So it will give you a lot of other details also. Yeah, that's all for today. So looks to be a little interesting. So you will be able to manage multiple cell application into a same terminal application. Maybe we need to wait for any other improvements Windows is planning. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.